Let's see how to use a physical USB flash drive, such as this one, to boot a VirtualBox virtual machine. So usually when working with VirtualBox, we use an ISO file. But in this video, we're going to see how to use an actual USB flash drive, a physical one, and boot an operating system from this physical device. So first, of course, we need to have a bootable USB flash drive. I already have one. And to do that, you can use something like Balena Etcher, Rufus, or Ventoy. On this one, I have Ventoy installed, but the procedure we'll cover here will work for any other way to create such a bootable USB flash drive. So let's start by plugging it in. Next, we need to locate the VirtualBox installation folder. By default, this is the installation folder, C Program Files Oracle VirtualBox, but in case you installed it anywhere else, we're going to see how you can find the installation folder of VirtualBox. So here's how we're going to do it. We're going to look for it in the Windows Start menu. And once we find it, we can right-click on VirtualBox, and then we choose Open File Location, and it leads us to the shortcut to VirtualBox. So once again, I'm going to right-click on the link, on the shortcut, and once again, Open File Location. And now we can see the installation folder for VirtualBox, and you can see that in my case, VirtualBox is indeed installed in the default location, which is C, Program Files, Oracle, VirtualBox. Next, we need to open the Windows Terminal as Administrator. So I'll right-click on the Windows Start icon, then choose Terminal Admin. Next, we need to navigate to the VirtualBox installation folder. So this is the folder we found here. So I'm simply going to copy it, then change directory to this folder. Next, we need to identify the USB flash drive. In other words, we need to find the ID of the disk we want to boot from. To do that, we need to open the Disk Management utility. So I'll right-click on the Windows Start icon again, then choose Disk Management, here it is. And here, we can see all of the disks we have on this computer. So among these disks, we need to find the bootable one, the one we created with Balena Etcher or Rufus or Ventoy. As I said before, I used Ventoy, so here it is. It got the letter E, and the disk containing this drive, the E drive, is disk 2. So for me, the USB flash drive that we want to work with is disk 2. So we identify the disk, let's move on. Next, we need to create a VMDK virtual disk. This virtual disk that we are about to create is basically a link, and it allows a VirtualBox virtual machine to work with a physical disk. So here's the command that we're going to run, and it can only be run from the VirtualBox installation folder. That's why we had to navigate to the VirtualBox installation folder, and we are already here. So I'm simply going to copy this command and paste it. And we need to replace physical drive 1 with the ID of the actual disk, the disk that we identified in the Disk Management utility. So in my case, the bootable USB flash drive was disk 2. And that's why here we need to replace physical drive 1 with physical drive 2. And here, we need to choose a name for the virtual disk that we are about to create. You can use the name virtual disk, or you can use any other name you want. I'll call mine virtual disk 2. And virtual disk 2 was created. If we now open the VirtualBox installation folder, we can see it here, virtual disk 2. .vmdk. Next, we need to open VirtualBox, but we have to do it as administrator. To allow VirtualBox to access physical hardware, we must run it as administrator. So let's look for VirtualBox, and let's run it as administrator. And let me create a new virtual machine. And now, we need to add the virtual disk to the new virtual machine. So we need to open the virtual machine's settings, then navigate to storage. And it can be found here, here it is, storage. And where it says controller SATA, we need to click on the icon to add a new hard disk. So this is the icon, let's click on it. Then we need to click on add. And we need to look for the new VMDK file we just created. So as you probably remember, we can find this file in the VirtualBox installation folder. And here it is, virtualdisk2.vmdk. So let's choose this disk. Next, we need to adjust the disk order. The idea is that we want this disk to be the first option. So the order of the disks here is determined by their port number. So as we can see, this, the first option, uses port 0, then the second one uses port 1, and then the third one, the one we just added, uses port 2. What I'm going to do is to change the number for the first two. So this is going to be, let's say, port 3. And this is going to be something else. Doesn't really matter, let's say port 5. And then for the VMDK file, I can assign port 0. And now the virtual machine will use this option as its first option. It will try to boot from this disk. That's what we want. And if we now start our virtual machine, we can see that it boots from the physical USB flash drive right into Ventoy.